Easy Riders, I'm Gary from Real Tours, and this is 5 On, the series on our YouTube channel in which we give you 5 minutes of trivia about a specific film. This episode is all about The Wicker Man from 1973. Spoiler alert, this video will contain plot spoilers. Stopwatch at the ready, roll film.
And here we go.
Christopher Lee was looking to avoid typecasting by working on non-Hammer horror productions, and he loved the Anthony Schaffer script so much that he decided to appear in the film without charging a fee, so that parts of the budget could be spent elsewhere. Upon the opening of the film in England, distributors had such little faith in it that it was heavily edited down and released at the bottom of a double bill, along with Don't Look Now. After both appearing in this film together, Christopher Lee and Britt Eklund then went on to land roles in the next James Bond film, The Man with the Golden Gun, which was released in 1974. The wonderful but sadly now defunct film magazine Cine Fantastique dubbed The Wicker Man the Citizen Kane of horror movies and dedicated an entire issue to the brilliance of this film. The first choice for the role of Sergeant Howie was Basil Expedition himself, Michael York, however he was unavailable. It was then at this point that screenwriter Anthony Schaffer and producer Peter Snell recommended Edward Woodward, who coincidentally had always been their preferred casting anyway. Lindsay Kemp, who plays the landlord of the Green Man Inn and Willow's father in the film, was actually only 4 years older than his on-screen daughter, Britt Eklund. Lord Summerisle's speech about living amongst the animals is actually a paraphrased version of a poem by Walt Whitman. When Sergeant Howie visits the school whilst inquiring about Rowan, one of the students, named Daisy, reveals a beetle that is tied to a nail with a piece of string. The girls in the class are supposed to be 12, however, Leslie Mackey was actually 21 years old at the time of filming. The film all takes place between the 29th of April until the 1st of May, however, it was actually filmed in October and November during 1972. Christopher Lee would often refer to The Wicker Man as the best film he's ever worked on. The final scene with the burning of The Wicker Man was filmed in Burrowhead, which today is a caravan holiday park. It was so cold during the time of filming that the actors all had to have ice cubes placed inside their mouths so that you couldn't see their breath on screen. If you visit Burrowhead, you can still see the remnants of where they actually burned the wicker effigy. The stumps were stolen from the site in the mid-noughties, however, you can still see the final fragments of the prop in the ground. I visited the location in September 2017, and it's one of my favourite cinematic pilgrimages. The lyrics to the opening song, Corn Rigs Are Bonnie, were actually written by Robert Burns in 1775, and then later put to music for this film in 1972. Britt Eklund was assured that they would only film her from the stomach up during the seduction dance sequence. However, once she'd finished filming her segment, the production team sneaked in a body double to film all of the bare-bottomed door-banging shots. The body double was Lorraine Peters, who wore an ill-fitting blonde wig during these scenes. To this day, if Britt Eklund is given photographs to sign featuring this famous scene, she refuses, as it wasn't actually her on screen. Britt Eklund's voice was dubbed in the film by actress Annie Ross. Eklund wasn't actually aware of this until she saw the film for the very first time in cinemas, and she was extremely upset as she'd spent many hours working with a dialect coach to perfect her Scottish accent. A few years after the film's release, Rod Stewart supposedly attempted to buy all rights so that he could destroy all traces of the film, as he was dating Britt Eklund and didn't want others to see her seduction scene. It's rumoured that the original negative of the full-length version of the film was used as landfill in the construction of the M3 motorway in England. Christopher Lee believed that this was done on purpose because of the production company's dislike of the film. Just before they began shooting the climactic scene with Edward Woodward trapped inside the Wicker Man, he said that there was a particularly anxious goat in a cage located just above his head, which urinated all over him just as they began to film. The production company's advertising executives were so appalled at the final scene of the film that they tried to convince screenwriter Anthony Schaffer and director Robin Hardy to rework the ending. They suggested that Sergeant Howie's life could be spared by a sudden rainstorm breaking out which would extinguish the flames. Of course, Schaffer and Hardy both refused to do this. During filming, Britt Eklund claimed that Galloway, which was one of the locations, was the bleakest place on Earth. This comment irked many of the locals, and the producers had to apologise to the community on her behalf. In the 2006 Nicolas Cage version of The Wicker Man, which if I had my view would be erased from existence, the missing girl is named Rowan Woodward in homage to Edward Woodward. Edward Woodward was offered a cameo in the remake in 2006, however he declined the offer. Much of the American press tour during the film's initial release was funded by Christopher Lee himself. The studio thought that the film was terrible and didn't want anything to do with it, so to try and drum up an audience, Christopher Lee travelled to numerous small towns in the States that were screening the film in order to promote it. He even appeared on several public access shows to give interviews about it. Well, there we go, time is up. I hope that you learned something new there. If you haven't seen The Wicker Man in a while, then this is the perfect time to revisit it because it is a true cinematic masterpiece. What film would you like us to cover next? Let us know in the comments below. We release videos weekly, so be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and also click the bell to receive notifications on all future videos. Keep it real.
It is time to keep your appointment with The Wicker Man.